April, I guess the bigger news today is the Manila Water news, because last Friday it was in training suspension. That is going to be lifted today at 10 a.m. But we're getting news that Enrique Lizon is buying 25% of Manila Water for 10.7 billion pesos. That's around 820 million shares at 13 pesos a piece. Is Lizon to the rescue? Does this spell the end for Manila Water's problems?
Well, hopefully it will spell the end. I mean, at least it should boost some confidence that, this company is not going to be bankrupt and the government will, not nationalize it, and that the government will allow the extension eventually of the water concession from 2022 to 2037. So it should be a confidence booster for the water companies, not only for Manila Water, but also for the likes of MPI-DMCI, who own shares in Maynilad.
But I guess if you were Enrique Lizon, why would he do this? We have heard that he's been buying up the stocks over the past 2 weeks. Finally, it's confirmed. What sort of message does this send to investors? And considering he bought it at 13 pesos a piece, do you think that's fire sale price, considering that back in 2017, Manila Water shares were trading at what, 32, 31 pesos a piece?
Yes, I think for us, like when we did the numbers in CUL Financial, I think our fair value, if we take out the taxes, the tax angle, it's still worth more than 13 pesos. But of course, I guess the uncertainty is what kind of a contract will the government present to them for them to be allowed to operate and to extend and not to be nationalized. And it's probably, maybe based on their computations, it's going to be more than 13 pesos, which is why they bought it there, which is highly possible based on our estimate. So yeah, I think it's a good signal, because like even on our assessment, I think the reaction of investors initially was a sell first, ask questions later. But logically speaking, I think it's very difficult. The government has sent signals that, I don't think we can afford to operate it. We know how to operate this water concession, So we're willing to sit down and talk about it. Except that, of course, there still is a lot of fear, which is why investors continue to stay on the sidelines. And, let's just wait for all the information to come out. But, rationally speaking, it looks like really it's going to be a win-win situation for both parties.
April, investors here have scheduled events to consider: the inflation data out Wednesday, the Philippine Central Bank decision on Thursday. To what extent do you think these could serve as catalysts for risk appetites, or could they still be drowned out by the virus contagion fears or the peak fear, as Steven Enes of Axie Corp was telling me earlier?
Yeah, I think the focus will be on the coronavirus and the potential impact on the economy, because that's really the greatest uncertainty. Excuse me. Because as far as inflation is concerned, I think it's pretty much consensus that the expectation is for inflation to pick up a little bit for the month of January. And, based on my assessment, whether or not the BSP cuts rates during the BSP meeting, it doesn't really matter, because you have some economists saying that the BSP will cut rates, whereas there are some that say they won't. And at this point, it's not yet that critical that they do anything, because inflation doesn't look like it's going to exceed the 2-4% range anyway, and a little bit adjustment here and there isn't critical. So most likely the focus will be on the updates on the coronavirus.
And April, going back to, I just wanted to go back to Enrique Lizon. Who is Enrique Lizon? And if he is Lizon to the rescue of Manila Water, I think we have a graphics of this. Enrique Lizon, of course, is a port magnate. He's also behind Solaire Resorts and Casino. He's done businesses all over the world. Running ports is no easy task. He's done it in Asia Pac, Latin America, Middle East, Africa. And he's also into water. Wawa Dam is led by Lizon. It's supposed to start supplying additional 80 million liters per day to Metro Manila by the year 2021. How do investors see Lizon? I'm very curious. Yeah. Is he known as this very bold investor who just strikes it out anywhere? I mean, he's done it all over the world.
I think he is well-respected. I think if you look at the share price performance of his stocks for 2019, they have been the more resilient you know, stocks and valuations have been very good. So definitely, in terms of competence level, I believe that investors feel that he is very competent. And given that he is going to do the Wawa Dam, then maybe it shows that he is knowledgeable about this business. He's not like somebody who just wants to do it for the first time and, you know, he sees an opportunity, he buys it, but he doesn't know anything.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to see how investors will react to the news, because Manila Water shares will begin trading today at 10 after that voluntary trading suspension is lifted. In the meantime, Kathy, at the foreign exchange market, the peso opens weaker, 50.95 against the U.S. dollar from last Friday's close of 50.83. Kathy?
Okay, back with you both in 7 minutes for the opening bell.